all at once. And even wise men traveled a long distance just to pay homage to him. Oh, it was so wonderful. And I have to admit that like any other mother, I held my child in my hands. I played with his little hands and his little toes, and I just hugged him, this borrowed child, this child of God that God had given to me, this special one that I, Mary, the common one, had been chosen to carry and to raise. Oh, how wonderful he was. I vowed right then that one day I would make him a special garment without any seams, that when he grew older, I would make this garment for him because I knew that he was so special. I wanted to make a garment that would be fit for the deliverer of Israel. You know, over the years, I've had many people ask me, what was it like being Jesus's mother? Was it hard? Did he need to go in time out? Was he cranky? Did he get along with his brothers and sisters? I have to say that he was so wonderful. But the most difficult part about being his mother was the fact that he was perfect and I was not. When he was just young, he used to love to go into the temple and he used to listen to the words of the Torah, and then he used to go and try to teach those who were our leaders. And sometimes when I went into the carpenter shop, I would hear him working side by side with Joseph, his father, and they would be arguing about the Torah and about their faith. They would be having discussions and laughing. And sometimes I would worry. Sometimes I would say to Joseph, there's so many things that fill his head. Is he going to be all right? And Joseph would say to me, Mary, Mary, he's been chosen for this. He has a calling. He has come to teach us, to show us the new way, to challenge our laws, to show us that through God, all things are possible. It wasn't until Jesus was in his early 30s that he began his ministry. I had to admit that sometimes I was wondering if he would ever leave the house. But you see, I was so excited. I couldn't wait for him to get out there. I couldn't wait for him to begin his ministry because I knew that he was the one. He was the one that we had been waiting for. And I was so excited. I just thought that everybody would love him the way that I loved him, and that everybody would see his wisdom and would be touched by his compassion. Can you imagine how I felt when he preached in our own town and the people turned away from him and the people mocked him and the people would have killed him? But God knew that it wasn't his time. Oh, but over the next several years, the things that he did were wonderful. His ministry grew and grew. I saw him give sight back to the blind, give hearing to those who couldn't hear anymore. I watched him go up and heal the lepers. I saw him go up and to preach love and compassion. I watched him as he reached out to those that society had turned away from and welcomed them in. He welcomed the prostitute and the widow and the tax collector. He broke all the rules in love. I saw him feed thousands. I heard he walked on water. And as news of Jesus spread, people came from all over to hear my son, to be near him, to know his teachings. It grew and grew. But now when I look back, I have to say that as he became more popular, as people came to him and started to listen to him, there were more and more people who began to hate him. There were more and more people who began to plot against him.
Oh, I was there. I was there that wonderful day when he rode a donkey into Jerusalem gates. I was there when people shouted, Hosanna, Hosanna to the one who comes in the name of the Lord. And my heart was filled with joy as I said, this is the time I've been waiting for. This is what the angel Gabriel promised, that this would be our deliverer. Oh, I was so excited. I could just imagine what he would be like being the leader of Israel. I just knew that he would be the one that would be filled with compassion and that there would be no other leader like him at all. I was so excited. I knew that finally my son was going to be seen for who he was. Oh, but how wrong I was. How wrong I was. Those shouts, Hosanna, in just a few short days, turned into horrible accusations as one of his closest friends and confidants turned against him, as the leaders plotted against him, as the crowds that once shouted and waved palms now were saying, crucify him, kill him. And when they had the opportunity to let him go, they did not. Can you imagine the pain of seeing your son beaten? Can you imagine how a mother's heart breaks when they placed a crown of thorns on his head and they made him carry that ugly, ugly cross up onto that hill? And then I watched as they took those hands that I had played with when he was a child and they pierced them with nails and they nailed his feet to the cross. I stood at the bottom of that cross in disbelief, weeping uncontrollably as I watched my son, the Son of God, the Son of promise, the one that I had believed would come and be our deliverer, die. And as I looked into his eyes as he took his last breath, I still saw love. And when he died, the earth turned black and the ground beneath my feet shook and I felt sorrow like I have never felt before. It was painful for me to even breathe. And they took my broken child down off of the cross. They took his broken body and they wrapped it and they placed it in a borrowed tomb. I just sat there, stunned, filled with shock and horror. I don't even remember, but I've been told that the other women gathered me and told me that the Sabbath was coming, and they brought me into a room. I don't remember celebrating the Sabbath. I don't remember. All I remember is tears and sorrow and heartache and pain and hopelessness. A hopelessness that you can't just shake away. A hopelessness that fills every cell in your body. It was the darkest day. And on the evening of the Sabbath, Mary Magdalene, Salome, and James's mother Mary came and said that they were going to get up early and they were going to go to the tomb and they were going to place spices and ointment on his dead body. And they asked me if I wanted to come. My heart is too broken, I said. I don't think my legs will work. I can't. And so early the next morning, before the sun was even up, I could hear the women quietly moving around the room. They thought I was sleeping, but how could I sleep? A mother should never see their child murdered. And I just sat there in the darkness, feeling nothing. And then I heard it, screams, yells, shouts. At first, I thought it was the soldiers. I thought they were coming to get us. I thought that the horror of this time had not come to an end. I thought, oh my goodness, here they come. But then the door burst open and Mary came running in and said, Mary, Mary, come, the tomb is empty. He is risen, I have seen Jesus. I can tell you that I was stunned. I didn't know if this was true or not, but in my head I could hear the words, with God all things are possible. And I ran as fast as I could and I got to the tomb and there he was, my son. He said, Mary, mother, didn't you believe? Didn't you know that this is the way it was supposed to be? And so I gather here today, and I tell you, I have come to tell you, the tomb was empty. This child that was born in Bethlehem so long ago, that was promised to me, this miracle child, he rose again. He rose so that you and I can have eternal life. He rose so that you and I would have our sins forgiven. He died on the cross for our salvation. Oh, people of God, I know it's hard to believe. I know that in your day and in this time, people are turning away from the word of God. They are questioning and they are saying this is a fairy tale. But I am here to tell you, do not let my son die and rise again in vain. Take this story to your heart. You are an Easter people. God loves you beyond your wildest imaginings, and God is calling you to go forth and proclaim the good news. The tomb was empty. My son lives again. My son is here. All you need to do is open your heart, and you will know the joy of Easter. Be bold, people. Go forth and tell the story until all the world rejoices and says, Alleluia, Alleluia, he is risen indeed.